In 2020, people spent over $250 million on over-the-counter fertility tests such as ovulation predictor tests. There is limited evidence that these costly kits help improve the chances for pregnancy for most people. Watch this video for more information about that. Unfortunately, some companies have resorted to misleading advertising to capture your hard-earned money. Today on Infertility TV, I am going to review some of these products and reveal the actual science behind them. Joy Pai asked my opinion about a urine test from a company called Proov. According to their website, they claim to be able to determine ovulation quality with a urine test for a hormone called PdG, and that a clinical study shows that elevated PdG on specific days after suspected ovulation, during what is known as the implantation window, is associated with a 92% chance of successful pregnancy compared to only a 19% chance in those with lower PdG levels. Let's look at this claim a little more closely. After ovulation, the corpus luteum in the ovary produces a huge amount of progesterone. Progesterone is responsible for preparing the uterine lining for implantation and then maintaining it afterwards. Eventually, progesterone in the blood circulates through the liver, where it is changed or metabolized into over 30 different molecules. One of those molecules, PdG, is eventually excreted from the kidneys, where it can be measured in the urine. Before ovulation, progesterone levels in the blood are low and PdG levels in the urine are low. After ovulation, progesterone levels in the blood are high, and so PdG levels in the urine also get higher. Do PdG levels in the urine indicate ovulation quality? First of all, that is a made-up term. There is no medical or scientific concept of ovulation quality. Ovulation is the release of an egg from the ovary. A person either ovulates or not. There is no quality of ovulation. What about that study? I reviewed that study closely. That study did not look at PdG levels during the implantation window, as they claimed, but rather it looked at PdG levels in people that were already pregnant. PdG was being used as a method to monitor pregnancies in the first trimester. That study, by the way, was published a long time ago, 1978. Today, we have much better ways to monitor pregnancies, for example, with HCG blood tests and ultrasounds. That study had 76 pregnant people collect all their urine for 24 hours on four separate occasions, not just a one-time collection such as with this test. There is no evidence that these two methods are equivalent. What about other studies? There have never been any clinical studies which proved that measurement of urinary PdG helps identify people who are more or less likely to become pregnant. Most of the studies in this area are of poor quality. The best study is this one from the National Institutes of Health from 1999, which studied 215 healthy ovulating women. This was a comprehensive study that looked at a number of urinary hormones. However, they did collect a single urine specimen during the implantation window and tested the PdG levels. They compared the PdG levels in months where pregnancy occurred and months where it did not occur. They found that the PdG levels were no different. Thus, the claim that this test helps determine the quality of ovulation is not supported by the best scientific data. Can it be used just to determine if ovulation occurred? Yes, but it is not as accurate as existing methods. Compared to using a home urine LH kit or even just looking at cervical mucus, this study found that urinary PdG testing missed ovulation anywhere from 5 to 15% of the time. This study found it missed ovulation 19 to 41% of the time. Another section on their website that some would think is misleading is their claims about what FDA clearance means. The implication I had from reading this is that the FDA has performed a detailed review of the claims and agrees with those claims. This is not true. All FDA clearance means is that the technology used for this test is similar to a device that has already been cleared. in this case, a saliva test for progesterone. In fact, the FDA explicitly states that clearance does not in any way denote official approval of the device. Any representation that creates an impression of official approval of device because of complying with this pre-market notification regulations is misleading and constitutes misbranding. Another test for sale on this site was a urinary FSH test. FSH is a hormone from the pituitary gland. Blood levels of FSH are used by infertility doctors to help identify which people with infertility may have a low reserve of eggs remaining. People with low ovarian reserve do not respond to fertility medications as well, and with treatments like IVF, have higher cancellation rates and therefore lower success rates. There is no data that urinary FSH testing is of any benefit in assessing ovarian reserve. In fact, this study looked at several hundred people without infertility and looked at their urinary FSH levels. They compared people with abnormally high levels of urinary FSH to people with normal levels. After 6 months, and again after 12 months, there was no difference in the number of people who became pregnant based on their urinary FSH levels. In other words, urinary FSH is a completely useless test. This company also sells supplements. One supplement is called Luteal Love, which is an herbal blend that, quote, supports your body's progesterone production. This contains some common and completely unproven herbal supplements. In this episode, I discuss the fact that there is no data showing any benefit to these supplements and that there are very real risks to using them. For example, the ashwagandha in this supplement is frequently contaminated with industrial chemicals like lead, mercury, and arsenic. The other product they sell, called balancing oil, contains progesterone drops that are applied to the skin. Progesterone absorption from the skin is highly variable depending on where it is applied, what the progesterone is mixed with, the dose, and the frequency. It has never been shown to be of benefit for people with fertility problems, although they do not directly state this on their website. When I wrote to them to ask if they had any data about it improving fertility, they replied that, quote, "We do not keep track of that information as it falls outside of our intended use of it being a cosmetic to enhance beauty." It is clear, however, that infertility patients are who they are trying to sell this to. They prominently mention that this is, quote, fertility doctor advised, and they have fertility experienced customer support. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Many companies will try to prey on your desperation to become pregnant to sell you useless tests and treatments. It is important that you be an educated consumer and don't waste your money. For more information, check out our Fertility Scams playlist for other things to avoid. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.